Welcome, everyone. We're excited to be together. We're always excited to be together. When we are together, there's always something that's just right here, right in this atmosphere that God has for us. Don't touch that dial because God has something specific for you. Don't prejudge it. Don't judge it based upon anything I say or how I look. God help us. But realize something, that wherever two are gathered in His name, He said, I am there in the midst of you. Now, this is a new series, and we've entitled it Pit to the Palace, and I'm going to interchange the word pit and prison because they're the same thing. And the most important thing that I can say to you right now, right up front, is that we have a prophetic promise for you. It's a prophetic promise. What's a prophetic promise? It's a living word. It's a word that's moving. It's agitated in a good sense. It's activated from the very life and grace and power and mouth of Almighty God. It's an activated word. Okay, it's got something in it that's moving and living. It's bubbling and coming forth in our lives. And everything that God does, He does first by a prophetic word. When He created the universe, how did He do it? He did it by fiat. He did it by His word. So I know that, and this is what I want you to get more than anything else, that God has a prophetic promise for you. The house of destiny was built on the prophetic. It's just simply God forthtelling, God letting us in on, in terms of what He's thinking, in terms of what He wants to do. And whatever God wants to do, He wants to move His people. He's using His people, and then He's moving His people into that place so that God can manifest by His grace, but always through His church. Jesus said, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. What is a pit? And what is a prison in our lives? It's something that's binding. It's something that's confining. It's something that is suffocating, and it's restraining, and it's keeping one from being able to be free and to be loosed. Now, do you really think that there is a prison designed by the circumstances of life or designed by the devil himself for you that will be able to contain you, that will be able to successfully hinder you? I want to tell you the reason why we are here today, and this is, we're here and we're sent to you. The House of Destiny is sent to you right now with a prophetic word that says that the pit and the prison that you have been cast in cannot and will not successfully be formed against you. If you look at Genesis through Revelation, and I tried to do this in my study time unsuccessfully in terms of being able to exhaust all those in Scripture who were thrown into the pit or who were cast into prison. But you yourselves know there were many Bible characters, there were many biblical leaders, most all of them, and great prophets who visited the prison. So don't think it strange that you're in a prison right now. I've come here to prophesy to you that God sees you in that place, But God did not make the prison for you, but God will use that prison, actually, as a stepping stone for His kingdom. Why? Because God doesn't waste a thing. Sometimes, again, going into a service, going into a broadcast, going into a meeting, I just have a word. I just have a simple word that's in my spirit. Maybe not a teaching, maybe not an outline, but I love, that's all I need, that's all we need is a word from God. If you have a word from God, if you have God's promise, then my friends, you have it all. Because what has commonly happened in every character of the Bible is that first God gives them a word, and then all hell comes against them, and the exact opposite takes place. And it appears to be by God's design. No, I'm not saying that God brings evil against us. He doesn't need to help the devil. That's the devil's responsibility. But remember that where we live, remember that we live in a world that is contrary to the will of God. But never forget this. This is a world that Jesus died for. This is a world that He gave His very life's blood for. And so let's not sell people short when Jesus paid the very price of His very life for them. That's why we're here. We're here to share the salvation that God provided through His Son, Jesus Christ, to the whole wide world. A world that is dead set against God. Yes, they are. A world that itself is in a prison. A world that itself has been cast into a pit. But I want you to know that Joseph, who had a very profound prison pit experience, God brought him straight to the top. Straight to the top. And remember that he was only 17 years of age when his brothers threw him into the pit. And he was 30 years of age when Pharaoh made him second in command of his entire kingdom. I want you to remember two words. Never forget these very two simple yet profound words. God's enough. God's enough. I want you to say these words out loud to yourself. God is enough. Because I promise you, you're going to get to a place in your life where you have nothing else to hang your hat on except God, to hang your existence on. You will have nothing else to hold on to but God. You know, and sometimes that's just by design. And what's beautiful is that a great proof of God's existence is the radical transformation of someone's life. Listen to this little testimony, but it's powerful. I was homeless. I got into drugs. I went into prison. Then I found Jesus, and He changed my life. Now, I have a home. Now I have a wife. And now I have a lovely daughter and a new identity. I am a child of God. That is evidence that God exists, that God lives. When He can miraculously change a person who is in the pit, seemingly born for the pit, and He takes them to the top, that's how people realize that God exists. We overcome by the word of our testimonies. Now, we have to ask ourselves an important question. Can we remain faithful when we're cast into a prison of some sorts circumstantially? Because I'm not going to prophesy you to a pit, but that's going to happen. Whether you lose your job or whether something bad happens in any aspect of life. That's just the world that we live in. But we don't have to be afraid of that. God's always with us. Remember that. He's always there. He's always the one who opens the door. He's always the one that lifts us out of the pit. So remember Joseph. Remember when he accurately interpreted the butler's dream. Remember when he asked the butler to remember me, he said, when it becomes well with you, because he prophesied the butler back to the top, who was in prison with Joseph actually at the time. Genesis 40 and verse 23 says, yet the chief butler did not remember Joseph, but forgot him. You see, people are going to forget you. Stop looking to man. The fear of man is a snare, but whoever trusts in the Lord will be saved. If you want to be victorious against the pit, then you have to focus your eyes on Jesus Christ. And when men fail you, you will not be disappointed. When men fail you, you will not fail, because you're not standing on a foundation that was established and built by mere man, but you're standing on a foundation that is established and built by God. Remember this, when you are locked into the pit and the prison, God is never locked out. When the butler forgot about Joseph and Joseph had to serve years more time, he still was not going to be locked in that place forever, because God was with him. Remember Ecclesiastes 7 and 8 as I close right now. And we'll pick up the next time, part 2. The end of a thing is better than its beginning. The end of a thing is better than its beginning. Someone you know, someone you love, is in the pit of death. They're dying right now. Now, I'm closing with this. That's it. God will either raise them up or He'll take them home. But remember, it's the end of a thing that you and I are to focus on, not the beginning. The beginning is full of snares and attacks. There's lack there, there's immaturity there, there's fumbling and stumbling and a lot of learning going on, but it's the end. It's God bringing us to the finish line. Although we have an eternity with God, we'll never be finished. But the end thing is that which God wants you to focus on, not the beginning. Because like Joseph, like Job, and like Jesus, their end and your end will be glorious. Father, bless this word. Bless your people. Now, release your supernatural prophetic promise over them. In Jesus' name, amen. God opens up doors that no man can open. God opens opportunities for us because we're in His kingdom, because we're His children. And God has a plan. He's a mastermind. He's the God of all wisdom. And God wants to give us wisdom today, wisdom to prosper. As John said, I wish above all things. Think about it. This was his prayer, that you would prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. It begins with the soul. So as we're taking this moment to worship God together in our giving, this is something we want. We want to listen to God right this very moment. Listen to His voice. Listen to what He's saying to us. And then release our faith in obedience. And your obedience will bring blessings, far greater blessings than you can ever ask or imagine. So Heavenly Father, we thank you for your abundant supply. There's people here that have tremendous needs as I speak. But do not consider the lack, do not consider the shortage, but consider the fact that your Father owns the universe. And He speaks provision and prosperity with a word. And so, for you, all things are possible. God is giving you a promise, and He is faithful. That says it. In Jesus' name. Receive it now. Take it by faith. Amen.
Hello, House of Destiny family. Thank you for worshiping with us today. We want to hear from you. We want to hear all the good things that God is doing in your life. And if you have a prayer request, make sure that you send both of those to hope@houseofdestiny.org. And we want to remind you of all the viewing options that we have for all ages. Of course, we have our regular broadcast on Saturdays and Wednesdays. And then we have Monday, which is Prophetic Rewind, which is everything Prophet Kim Clement that he ministered with. And then on Friday is all things Israel. Then we have Destiny Kids and Destiny Worship. So make sure that you gather your family, pick an option, and we are so excited to be a part of your life.